What's up, y'all? We're back at it again. This time we're doing Sigma Fortress 2. Polishing that up because the other one was pretty raw. And since now we have the raw guitar waves, we're not gonna deal with the contact, with that awful tuning that the contact had. I don't know why, but yeah. So let's launch up SBC tool and hope it doesn't crash. Okay, so we have the guitar. And I do remember the guitar also has vibrato, so Renato doesn't have to warn me twice. Let's see, what's the delay on this? I think it's like one step, right? Yeah, I think it's like one step and... Okay. Step hand wave sample. So we're gonna copy everything from down here. And then we have more guitar stuff here. Thank you. So they're both gonna have like a one step delay. Let's do the envelope in this. See what you're saying, Renato. So there's this guy, Uncle Percy Chrono, tripping you with X1. Yeah, interesting. Someone also told Sam to do Chrono Trigger as well, but I guess someone already beat him to it. And plus, I don't think Sam's gonna do it because it's not a gamer, so he hasn't really played Chrono Trigger, I think. So, copy these notes. No, it needs to be a little higher. Let me check the pitch of the original guitar. Yeah, so it needs to be more higher. Yeah, right there. Wait, am I missing some notes? No, I'm not missing notes. Okay, let's add our delay. So what, it's a one step delay or something? Let me add a vibrato to that guitar. There we go. Let's do the other guitar layer. Yes, this can be a little bit complicated here. So they're in. Okay, so We can actually make a separate one, and they're both pan centered, so we don't have to worry about panning. Guitar 2. So now we're going to copy the other layer. See what you're saying when I do. This is an oblivious of life. But it's copy, and I want to make sure the pitch before I make any do something stupid here. That's the one. Oh my God. The other one needs rubato. Yeah, needs rubato. Just copy this over here. What I didn't want. No. What did I copy? Sure, sound pretty good. Oh yeah, good times indeed. And then I remember that when we corrected the pitch, the other one went off, and then we had to correct the other one, and then the other one was still off. Now it's all uniformed. Okay, so. But let me add a little chorus to it to kind of spread it out a bit. So let's chorus this one. Too much. Maybe not. Starts distorting it. Okay, well, we'll see how it sounds with the other elements. Okay, so we got the guitar done. Now we need the other elements. That last note sounded like me stepping on a toy box or something. Okay, and this is like the synth pan wave thingy. Copy too much. So let's name this one. Let's name this pattern. We're gonna call it. We're just gonna name this pattern melody. Okay, so let's keep the preset, see how it sounds. Synth melody. Let's do it a mixer track. Oh yeah, we had to change the notes to the color green. Yeah, Renato's favorite color, green. Like an avocado. Okay, so here we go. All right, and we have to add delay. That's pretty good. It's a bit low. Okay. It's a bit low, so we're gonna saturate it a bit. Perfect. Shut it. All right. So what's next? Oh wait, those little brass thingies. Okay, so copy these. And we're gonna drop it into the melody. Let's call this brass stab. We don't need that much of it on it. There we go. And the other center panned it, so we're just going to copy it from over there. There we go. Okay. Maybe give it a little bit exciter on it. Yeah, there we go. You know what else? We got that. We got those stabs here. So what else do we need? I believe we need the strings. Yeah, we need the strings for sure, definitely. Huh, and it crashed on me. Drop it in our melody. Yeah, this song is like everything's panned toward the center, which makes it easier. Okay, so bright strings. Now we've got to copy the other strings. Actually, you'll probably copy these ones because they're center pan this well. Let's copy them all. Oh, here's that string. Okay. Okay, so got those strings in here. See what else do we need? Got the strings. Got that, we got the stabs. Alright, we've got all these other elements in here. Okay, so now of course we have to go on to the percussion, which nobody likes, but it's gotta be done. At least it's something that will sound as raw. So we got those hats. All right. Thank you. Renato. Yeah, I'll try not to add some greens next time. There we go. Okay, so we need the crashes. Which will need another instance. Where's this supposed to start? All right, so symbols are looking good. So the snare. Let me see if the snare has no delays associated with it, but they shouldn't. And here's that Tom. Of course, it has to be. It can't be a Mega Man X song without a Tom. It crashed on me again. Why doesn't somebody take the source code and make like a, one that supports 64-bit processors and other advanced features and stuff, you know? And this is going to be a straight snare. Give it a mixer track. Let's do our usual snare tweaking. Saturate it. Add some chorus to it. There we go. And now to grab the tom. Wait, snare has pan? Nope, snare has no panning. And the tom, just gonna feels that it had a higher pitch. Yeah, that's the one. And I want to take off some of the low ends on that low end on the tom. Give it a high pass filter. We go. And I want to lower it a bit because it's too loud. Yeah, perfect. Okay. Save that, and now we need to kick. Another tom. I don't know already, is it delay on it? Whoops. Yeah, there is delay. So we need to add like a half a step delay or something. Give it. There we go. It was right on that one. Yeah. Perfect. Let's, pitch as well. Two, you're saying we're not okay. Yep, that's right, the snare thing. But the snare doesn't have a delay, so we don't have to worry about it. Tom does, but it's an easy delay, so. Okay, now we can copy the kick. Okay, so, and now for our bass. And that's the So making sure it wasn't like the synth bass, but no, that's the slap bass. Oh, what happened? Okay, so give it a mixer track. And let's bring out some of the low ends on him. See how it compares to the other one. Oh yeah, definitely. That bass is really audible. So let's see, are we missing anything else? See if we did this one already. Yeah. Alright, so we have the pieces of the puzzle, and now let's put them together. Got our melody. Ba, ba, ba. Okay, percussion. Slower a little bit. Okay, so things are shaping up. You know, now we just gotta add the final ingredients. Feel this needs needs a bit of chorus on it, just a bit. Actually, maybe not. Let's give it some release. There we go. Any objections before I start doing the TSAR reverb on it? We're not a TSAR? Yeah, definitely. I really don't think anything else really needs tweaking because it's already tweaked. Saturation, that brass tab is already. Maybe I could give it some life a little, but. It already has life, the strings. Okay, so yeah, it's TSR now. First add our plugins. I should have added the plugins before I should have saved my template, but whatever. I'll do that next time. I should have asked also Sam for his reverb template, his mixer channel template, because that always could be useful. I'm sure he wouldn't mind giving it to me.
Right, I forgot to dock my template. Tar's gonna go into the lead. Snare and everything except the bass can be busted through here. Alright, let's see how it sounds now. Okay, so let's see. Does the snare have the same config amount as previous songs? Yeah, for the most part, it should. I added the chorus, the saturation, and everything, and volume should be pretty much the same, except with, like, you know, the stuff like delays, that's exceptional to, like, a certain track that uses it, so. Let me give it one more listen. Actually, let me listen to it on here. Yeah, snare should have the same volume.
Yeah, should be about done. We're gonna export it. And get rid of that raw version. God, that was so raw. That was like so, you know, undercooked.
The kick is usually below the snare, and one barely hears it. Same lines for a song.
Yeah, the kick should, I just raised it, so it should be good now. Just that, you know, in the SCP, you're not going to hear that, you know, that kick because of that, you know, the frequency. But here with all your elements, it's a little bit different. You know, you're going to hear more of the high ends of the kick. Export the FLAC. And so that'll be it for tonight. Tomorrow we're gonna continue with the third fortress theme, and then we should be about more than halfway through. You know, polish some of the other current tracks I did before, like Zero and, you know, the Vile Boss theme and all that. And then maybe like go and adjust some of the other tracks, and that should be about it. We have 2 more Maverick things left. Actually, 3 more. That should be Storm Eagle and, let's see, Storm Eagle, Stink Chameleon. And what was that? What was that other one? It's with that, I guess that, no. I don't know. Let's see, what was that other one? Completely forgot. So we have, Spark Mandrill. Okay. So we have Storm Eagle, Spark Mandrill, and Stink Chameleon.